नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस कंटिन्यू द एक्सरसाइज 7.4। दिस इज द टॉपिक ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 9 चैप्टर नंबर 7 ट्रायंगल्स। वी विल स्टडी द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3। व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन? क्वेश्चन इज, हियर वी हैव गिवन वन ऑफ द फिगर। इन दिस फिगर एंगल बी इज लेस देन एंगल ए एंड एंगल सी इज एंगल is less than angle D. We have to show that AD is less than BC. Right? See, this is the diagram in which two triangles are there, OAB and OCB. And AD and BC are intersecting in a point O. So here we have, whatever the given condition we have to start from that. So first thing that we have given here is that angle B is less than angle A. Right? Angle B is less than angle A in a triangle AOB. So in this triangle we have given one of these conditions. Now we know that the sides opposite to the larger angle is longer. So the sides opposite to this angle B is AO. So here we write down AO. And here we write down the side opposite to the angle A is BO. BO. This we can write down according to the theorem, that is side opposite to greater angle is larger. Right? Okay, give it the equation number 1. Now in the same way, in triangle COD, in triangle COD, one more thing we have given, and it is that angle C is less than angle D. So the opposite side of angle C is OD. OD is less than, opposite side of this D is OC. This also we can write down, give it the equation number 2 first of all. We can write down the same reason, that is side opposite to greater angle is larger. Right? So now what we have to do? We have to prove that AD is less than BC. How we get the AD? Is AD is the addition of AO and DO. In the same way, BC is the addition of BO and CO. So see, AO is there, DO is there, BO is there, OC is there. So let us add equation number 1 and 2. So when we add these two equations, see these two equalities, sorry, not equation. We are not taking it as equations. We are giving it the inequality number 1, inequality number 2. So when we add what these inequalities, what we are getting? Left hand side is added with the left hand side, that is AO plus OD. And the right hand side inequalities, that is BO, is added with this OC. So what is AO plus OD? AO plus OD is AD and BO plus OC is BC. So this is our required result that we have to prove AD is less than BC. Right? So this is how we can prove this type of sum. Right? Now let us study the question number 4. AB and CD are respectively the smallest and longest sides of a quadrilateral ABCD. We have given the quadrilateral in the diagram. We have to show that angle A is less than angle C. First of all, we have to show that angle A is greater than angle C. So, one thing we have given is that AB is the smallest side. Out of the four sides, AB is the smallest side. And out of the four sides, CD is the longest side. So, we have to prove that first thing, that angle A is greater than angle C. So now let us join A and C. Right? When we join this A with the C, Why we join A and C? Because we, whatever the theorem we have is only applicable to the triangles. It is not for quadrilaterals. So we have to join one of the diagonals so that now we can apply the theorem in both these triangles. So first of all, here we have to join AC. Now two triangles are there, triangle ABC and triangle ADC. Now we can write down that in triangle ABC. What we can write down? We have to consider two sides, AB and BC. Can you say that which side is greater and which is smaller? Obviously, this side AB is the smallest side, because we have given that AB is the smallest side out of the four sides. So BC is greater, AB is the less. So we can write down that AB is less than BC, right? AB side is less than BC side. Now opposite angle of this AB side, opposite angle of this AB side is this angle, that is ACB. So angle ACB. At the same time, the opposite angle of BC side is this, that is BAC. Angle BAC. This we can write down, and the angle opposite to, angle opposite to longer side is greater. Right? So here give it the inequality number 1. In the same way, if we consider the triangle ADC, so in triangle ADC, the same thing we can write down, but which side we have to consider? Out of this AD and CD, which side is smaller or greater? We have given that CD is the longest side out of the four sides. So we can write down that AD side is less than BC side. Right? So the same thing we have to apply here. Opposite angle of this AD is, AD side is there, opposite angle is ACD. So angle ACD is less than angle, opposite angle of BC, that is CAD or BAC. CAD. Here also we have to write down the same reason that we have write down, that the angle opposite to longer side is greater. Give it the inequality number 2. So when we add both these, add inequalities 1 and 2. What we are getting? Left hand side is added with the left hand side. So angle ACB plus angle ACD is less than angle BAC plus angle CAD. Right? Now add both this angle. What we are getting? ACB plus ACD. That means the total angle C. Angle C. And less than sign is less than sign is there. BAC. BAC plus CAD. That means all angle A. So see, this is what we have to prove, that angle A is greater than angle C. So this is the first result that we get here. Right? Angle A is greater than angle C. The same way, the second result that we have to prove is angle B is greater than angle D. Angle B is greater than angle D. So now you can think that we have to join, connect this B and D so that we can get the two triangles. So join, first of all, join BD. BD. So two triangles are again constructed, the ABC and AC. So in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, which side is longer? See, AB is the smallest side. So AB side, we can write down that AB is the smallest side. So AB is less than BC. Now, opposite angle of this AB side, opposite angle of this AB side is, okay, so here we have to consider, not to consider triangle ABC. when we join B and D, we have two triangles ABD and CBD. So we have to consider triangle ABD. So in triangle ABD, again AB side is there and AB is the smallest side. So we can write down that AB is less than AD side. So the angle opposite to this AB side is ADB. Angle ADB is less than, angle opposite to this AD side is ABD. Angle ABD. So now you can know which theorem we have to use here. We have to use this, the same theorem, angle opposite to the longer side is larger. Give it the inequality number. Now in the same way, consider the another triangle, that is in triangle ABD, now CBD, in the triangle CBD. Here we know that the CD is the greatest side, so we can write down that CD is the greater side, AD is the, BC is the smallest side, so we can write down BC is less than CD, right? Now the angle opposite to the BC side is BDC. Angle BDC is less than, angle opposite to the CD side is DBC. Angle DBC. Give it the equality number 4. This two also we can write down according to this, the same theorem we have to use in all these inequalities, that the angle opposite to the longest side is greater. Now again add this 3 plus 4, when we add both these inequalities, what we are getting? Angle ABD, angle ADB plus angle BDC, BDC is less than angle ABD plus angle BBC, BBC. Now see, when we add ADB and DBC, ADB and BDC, that is the angle D. So we are getting angle D is less than, when we add both these angles, ABD and DBC, we are getting angle B. So this is our second required result. That is, angle D is less than angle B, or we can say that angle B is greater than angle D, right? So using this, the concept of the inequality in a triangle, we can prove this type of questions. Okay, so this is all about this lecture. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us.